I think I wrote 7.
7? The seconds?
0, 0.
0, 0. Okay.
Okay. Hi. Okay. Hi, everyone. I'm going to talk about React Cache today. Okay, so just some stuff about me first. My name is YiShu. This is my Twitter handler. I like coffee. I just realized what's factorial. So I'm going to lose all my time from now. Okay, so this started off with, I was having a call with a colleague, and then we're talking about like how he was very tired with using Redux, and then he was like, oh, I'm very tired, I don't want to write all those like boilerplate stuff. You know, why don't we just call fetch? Like, what's the deal? Why don't we don't just call fetch? And then he started talking about like, oh, you know about the React Cache thing? Like, if we use it, right, maybe we will never ever have to use Redux ever again. So that's when I started researching about it. So 5 things. Number 1, it exists because of suspense. So suspense is something that's already been shaped. If you have used it in production, you probably have used it already. You can use it to lazy load your code. Instead of using React loadable, is it something like that? I can't remember. Yeah, so this is like an alternative to it that you can actually break up your code. And then there's a part where you can say, like, before we fetch the file, there's a fallback that you can use. So for the longest time, I always thought that suspense just means that your component will either render your render stuff or it will render a spinner. But apparently, when I was going through Twitter, I realized that suspense is actually cooler than that. Like, it actually delays rendering of the content. So let's say, if you move from your feed to your profile, it's not that it goes to the profile page and then it renders a spinner. What it does is that it actually waits for a while. It waits for your profile. Let's say you already fetch your JS file already, come back already, then it goes to your profile. So it suspends, it pauses for a while before it goes to the next component, which is like, whoa. Okay, so I guess like, it's not like has a good. So if you are using suspense for like data for lazy loading, it's like you load a JS file for one component and then it will then call for the other JS file. If we can call for another JS file, we might as well call for like more data. So I guess like that's the thought process. So that is actually what's called React Cache. It's still not stable. In case you think this is a library, it's not a library, it's part of the React library itself. It's not a separate library. So, but it's still not stable. If you want to try it, you can try it now. So, and it's not because the React team is lazy. Yeah, so if you go to the repo, it's actually part of React repo package, React Cache. Tell you, no, really, it's really unstable. But then, we can have a demo now. Okay, so let's look at how it looks like first. Let me refresh. So it will actually call an API to get my Pokemon. It will come back. And then, if I render, okay, you see that actually more of the component that I render, it doesn't make that fetch anymore. Fetch, subsequent render, no fetching. So let's take a look at the code. Okay, so over here I have a fetch. I have a function called getBarbersaw, and then getBarbersaw is actually just a fetch. I do a bit of weird stuff because I realize my internet is quite fast. So after my promise come back, I will make it wait for 3 seconds before I resolve it. That's why at the start you can see it's a bit longer. And then this is where the magic comes in, create resource. My create resource will call this fetch function that I have. So over here, this is my actual, my app, there's nothing else other than is trying to render many, many copies of this Pokemon component. And this Pokemon component has this line where it tries to fetch the data. So what happened here is that React is actually trying to cache what I asked for. It knows that when I do a subsequent call to this fetch again, it's already in the cache already. So when I look, when I render more and more of my component, right, it actually can go and find inside the cache and be able to find like my data that's being fetched. Okay, so it can replace Redux in certain situations. If you are using Redux for just one thing, which is data fetching, you are going to go to an endpoint, do a fetch. When it comes back, you store in your store. The next time when you need it again, you look at your store, then your store got the information, you use it. If you don't want, you can invalidate it. If you are doing only that for Redux, actually, React Cache can replace what you are using Redux for. But then, there are a lot of other things you can do with Redux. Like for example, after you fetch your data, you put it in your store, right? Sometimes you have to mutate it. Like let's say your website will render a lot of these things. Then, when a user like a listing, you want to change the like to color, right? Then, you need a way to keep it at the central store, and that's not the React Cache that you have. So if you're doing more things to your data other than fetching, then probably you will still need Redux. Okay, so this goes to the mechanism. How does it work? Oh. Okay, so I found this really good example. Where is it? Okay. Okay, so this is my Pokemon component. Maybe it has many, many nested layer. Maybe the page have my Pokemon component. This is suspense, which is the boundary that you put around what you want to suspend. So over here, it tries to trigger a fetch. Don't have, it will suspend itself. And then it will actually go through all the layer until it hits your boundary. So your boundary is the one that actually tries to do the data fetch, and then it will tell your component that it can render already. Yeah, so okay, so our collective leader Ben actually wrote about it. I'm still trying to wrap my head around what this thing is trying to do. But then what happens is actually for React Cache is that it throws a fetch. It throws a promise out. So usually we do try catch throw. The throw, we usually throw an error. And then the closest layer of catch will catch it. But then we haven't realized it, but then that we can actually throw other stuff. We can throw the whole window, we can throw functions, we can throw a string, we can throw a promise also. So just now my Pokemon layer, right, what it did is that it threw a promise out, and then the suspend layer managed to catch it and fetch it for me. Okay, it's 0.5. Because I messed up. Okay, thank you.